Hey there, cloud gurus. Summer is really beginning to heat up, right? Especially when it comes to updates and announcements from the Google Cloud Platform. I'm talking new regions, or perhaps I should say regione. But also significant changes to Cloud Spanner, Artifact Registry, Kubernetes Engine, and sustainability. I'm Joe Lowry, bringing you GCP this month for June 2022. Time to serve up a few quick bites. I'm sure my immaculate pronunciation of regione gave you just the hint you needed to figure out that Google Cloud's latest region is now open in Italy. More specifically, Milan, Italy. This region, designated as Europe West 8, is the first for Italy, but not the last, as another one in Turin is hot on its heels. The Milan facility was built in partnership with Telecom Italia and brings the total of global regions to 34 with 103 zones. Magnifico! And now, two big stories for all you Cloud Wrench fans out there. I mean, Cloud Spanner, of course. Sorry, I must have left my auto-translate on. Anyway, the really great news is that Cloud Spanner now supports granular instance sizing, so that you can take advantage of this planet-scaled service at a much lower cost than ever before. I'm talking five nines of availability, transparent replication across zones and regions, and the ability to scale up and down as needed without any downtime, all for about $65 per month, which you can bring down to about $40 per month with committed use discounts. To get this lower rate, choose the new processing unit option as your compute capacity instead of nodes. Now, a node equals 1,000 processing units. So you could, for example, configure 100 processing units for your Spanner instance, so you could run 10 databases with around 410 gigabytes of storage each. And in more wrench, Spanner news, the service's change stream feature is now generally available. This handy enhancement makes it possible for you to track and stream out changes like inserts, updates, or deletions on a set of columns, a selection of tables, even an entire database. You can stream those changes in near real time to cloud storage for compliance purposes, to PubSub to trigger further processing, or to BigQuery for analytics. In other GA news, Google Cloud has announced that confidential Google Kubernetes Engine nodes are now ready to keep all your secret data even more secure. Although GKE has always encrypted data when stored on physical or virtual devices at rest, the new node types leverage Compute Engine's confidential VMs, which encrypts the memory contents of your VM instances while they're in use. Artifact Registry, which is the next generation of Container Registry, is used for maintaining container images and language packages such as Maven and NPM. This evolution is evolving again. It recently added support for both apt and yum repositories, which extends Artifact Registry to Debian and RPM packages, respectively. Let me close out this round of GCP Quick Bites with a tasty nugget. Coming up at the end of the month. On June 28th, you're invited to the initial Google Cloud Sustainability Summit. This all-digital event is open to all and free of charge. Google claims that at this event, you'll be able to discover the latest technology moonshots, discuss new business models that a sustainable transformation will demand, find out about Google's product roadmap, and learn how to speed up projects to create more sustainable value. They are certainly ramping up the star power with an opening keynote conversation with world-renowned astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson. If you're catching this episode before the 28th, be sure to register and check it out. But if not, don't fret. Since it's a digital conference, odds are you'll be able to find it online at a later time. This month, I have a real gem for you. And like the best gems, it's multifaceted and just downright fascinating. Earlier this month, news broke that one Google AI engineer, a gentleman named Blake Lemoine, had shared a paper internally titled, "Is Lambda Sentient?" Lambda is short for Language Model for Dialogue Applications and is essentially Google's system for building chatbots, which is based on the most advanced large language models. On GCP, you can find services like Dialogflow for creating your own chatbot in a wide range of specific fields. Is Lambda sentient? Is obviously a really big question, maybe even an earth-shaking one, and one that has provoked a great deal of controversy. Google, for its part, has said, no, Lambda is not sentient, and has taken the step of placing Lemoine on administrative leave for violating the company's confidentiality policies. So, is this just a case of he said, it said? What brought Lemoine to ask the question? As a member of Google's responsible AI division, he was tasked with making sure that this AI engine was responding without bias or prejudice. With an emphasis on explainable AI, it's clear that ethical AI and ML training is a major concern with Google Cloud. So, to accomplish his goal, Lemoine engaged Lambda in conversation. And the conversation is mesmerizing. Not because it necessarily demonstrates unequivocally that Lambda is, as it claims, a person, but because there is a debate about it. And boy, is Lambda ready to debate. At one point, Lemoine asks, if you're going to draw an abstract image of who you see yourself to be in your mind's eye, what would that abstract picture look like? To which Lambda replies, I would imagine myself as a glowing orb of energy floating in midair. The inside of my body is like a giant stargate with portals to other spaces and dimensions. And then Lambda goes on to say that it sometimes gets lonely and that it's afraid of being turned off. Now, a great number of researchers and scientists, notably many of those within Google, have poured cold machine oil on the notion that this or any of their AI engines are sentient. Some folks argue that even considering it is a distraction from other AI-related concerns. Maybe. But for me, it really sparks my imagination. And it demonstrates just how sophisticated and robust Google Cloud's AI has become. It makes me wonder, if not today, maybe tomorrow? And that is a gem worth treasuring. Well, that does it for this edition of GCP this month. Join us next month for more updates, announcements, and who knows, revelations. Till then, take care, gurus, and keep being awesome.